Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Our brothers and sisters, on this feast day of Padre Pio, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who by a singular grace gave the priest St. Pius Padre Pio a share in the cross of your Son, renewed, and by the means of his ministry, renewed the wonders of your mercy, grant that through his intercession we may be united constantly to the sufferings of Christ, and so brought happily to the glory of the resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Every word of God is tested. He is a shield to those who take refuge in him. Add nothing to his words, lest he reprove you, and you will be exposed as a deceiver. Two things I ask of you. Deny them not to me before I die. Put falsehood and lying far from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Provide me only with the food I need, lest, being full, I deny you, saying, Who is the Lord? Or, being in want, I steal and profane the name of my God. The word of the Lord.
Lord, I love your commands.
with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus summoned the 12 and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. And he sent them to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. He said to them, "Take nothing for the journey, neither walking stick, no sack, no food nor money, and let no one take a second tunic. Whatever house you enter, stay there and leave from there. As for those who do not welcome you, when you leave that town, shake the dust from your feet in testimony against them." Then they set out and went from village to village, proclaiming the good news and curing diseases everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord. Today we celebrate the feast of Padre Pio. And this is a quote from Padre Pio. He says, "Pray, hope, and don't worry." Too bad my mother never heard that. She was the official worrier for Fayette County, I think. One time I said to her, I said, "You know, Mom, you don't have to worry about everything." Her response was, "Well, somebody has to." Well, she continued to worry. We celebrate this feast day. Padre Pio was a Franciscan. And Franciscans really lived truly, even whenever they started with St. Francis, this basic teaching in the gospel today. Take nothing for the journey, neither walking stick, nor sack, nor food, nor money, and let no one take a second tunic. One of the things that St. Francis did from Italy, he would walk to the Holy Land. He walked there because he was trying to stop the battles between the Christians and the Muslims. Whenever he and another Franciscan took off for these long walks to go to these different countries, what did Francis take with him? He had a big old brown uniform or habit that he wore. Some people don't even think he took shoes. He walked barefoot from Italy all the way to the Holy Land. But he was sort of unsuccessful, so that meant he had to walk back barefooted. Could you imagine today going somewhere and not having these things? No food, no money, no clothes. In fact, if you try to travel today to get on an airplane, what's the first thing they're going to do? Check and see how much your suitcase weighs. If it weighs too much, you get to pay extra money, which is a wonderful thing. Well, in life, it would be nice if we could live this way, but it's a difficult way to live. 2,000 years ago, it was not too difficult for a person to do what the Lord said because they didn't have too much to begin with. When I think of Joseph and Mary heading from Nazareth or down to Bethlehem, you know, even if it was one day's walk, what did they take with them? There were no coolers to keep food in. They might have had a skin bag to put water in. But what did they take with them? Mary was with child, and yet off they went. She gave birth in the stable or whatever it was, and what was not present? There certainly was no sterile room. There was no doctor, there was no nurse, there was no one, just she and Joseph. And since neither of them had ever had a child before, it must have been interesting to try to figure out how they knew what to do or what not to do. In life, it is easier to travel with the less that you have. If you think about a lot of our worries and our concerns in life have to do with the things that we have. Right now in the South, Mississippi, Alabama, the states where Texas, where they're getting like a foot of rain every day, everything is flooded. The terrible thing is, it has become a great what to people? A great loss. The people living in California and out in the West where the fires are going, the reason why they feel so bad is because of the loss of so much that they had. It's all gone now. And yet think of these apostles going out to preach with no walking stick, not a sack, and no food and no money, and not even a change of clothes. I mean, like, that must have been interesting to wear the same clothes for day after day, month after month. In fact, I read one time during the American Revolution, the British soldiers, when they came to this country, everything that they owned, all the clothes that they were going to need, they had to wear. There were no bags, no change of clothes, no nothing. Can you imagine what those clothes must have been like after 1 or 2 years sleeping outside, trudging through the muck and the grime, sweating? It's kind of like, it's hard to imagine what they must have been like. But they certainly had nothing to worry about. I mean, they couldn't leave anything behind because it didn't have anything to leave behind. So we live in a time where we all have many possessions, but our great stumbling block right now is, what do we do with the world in which we live? They keep telling us, last night on the news, they said we have over 200,000 deaths in America. They claim by end of October or something, that number could double. That's a lot of people that's going to die between now and whenever. And we think about all the loss to families and everything else, that we have to somehow put into operation, I guess, the words of Padre Pio. Pray, hope, and don't worry, because worrying will get you what? Gray hair. That's what you get out of worrying. You have to really trust in the Lord. That's why probably the most apropos prayer that we could say each day, and we do, is the Lord's Prayer. Because the Lord's Prayer asks God to give us our what? Daily bread. Not bread for the week or the month or whatever, but to give us our daily bread. And so we have to learn to realize that life becomes cluttered the more things we have, because those are the things you have to keep lugging along with you. Every time I move, in fact, the last time I moved was from Ligonier to Greensburg in my retirement. I mean, I went and looked at the two rooms I have up at the Neumann House. And I went back home and I had to figure out which of these junks am I going to take with me. I only have two rooms. I had tons of artwork. I gave it all away. What am I going to do with it? I only have two rooms and each room only has four walls. How many pieces of art can you hang on one wall without tearing the walls down? I really got rid of a lot of things. It makes it a lot easier. In fact, when I became senior priest active here, Monsignor Riffle asked me if I wanted to move here and have a room here, and I said, "Oh, Ray," I said, "I already moved once. I'm not moving anymore." I said, "It's only a couple miles up there to here, so I'm not going to move. I'll just stay where I am." So be patient with yourself and remember to pray, to have hope. Don't worry, because God does hear our prayer, and somehow in His wisdom He will answer them. And our Father, to hear our needs.
That the Word of God, alive in His church, may raise up more missionaries and charity workers for the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders of nations may be moved by the Holy Spirit to depend more on God than on worldly power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are overwhelmed by difficulties will be blessed with the Lord's consolation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our faith community may continue to grow in faith and love as we work to spread the good news of God's kingdom on earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that those who have died may be given eternal refuge with Christ in his kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, St. Francis taught us to preach the gospel every day, and if all else fails, use words. The greatest teacher are our actions. We ask that you would guide us in them. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, fruit of your goodness we have received, the wine we own for you, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Spirit and treasure. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of Blessed Padre Pio, so that you, as you brought him glory, you may through these sacred mysteries grant us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Padre Pio you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, he broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and by recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Padre Pio, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 Let us pray. May partaking at the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high in all who celebrate the feast day of Blessed Padre Pio, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.